Student, now today we are in the fifth chapter, that is arithmetic progression. What is the meaning of the progress? Progress means going ahead. So in arithmetic progression means when you will add a fixed number to the previous number, preceding number, we'll get the next number. You see here I have taken three examples. See that conjugative natural number, then the another sequence is 4, 7, 10, 13, another sequence is multiple of 8. So three examples I have taken. So now here you can see one thing. Suppose if x is 1, then 2 will be x plus 1. If x is 1, then x plus 1 equal to 2. That means 1 plus 1 equal to 2. The next one, you see, if we are getting 2, that is x plus 1. Then x plus, what is the fixed number? Fixed number is 1. So x plus 1 plus 1. Similarly, x plus 2 plus 1 equal to x plus 4, and so on. Similarly, here you can see the difference between 4 and 7 is 3, 7 and 10 is 3, 10 and 13 is 3. So, if x is 4, 4 is x, then x plus 3 is the 7, then x plus 3 is the 10, then x plus 3 plus 3 how much? 6. X plus 6 plus 3 equal to 13. So that way you will go on. So that means, and similarly, see here 8. Then 8 plus 8 equal to 16. 16 plus 8 equal to 24. 24 plus 8 equal to 32. And same thing given here as well. Now one thing is you have seen that if we add a fixed number to the preceding number, automatically we will get the next number. Automatically we will get the next number means what? Succeeding number. Successive number. Okay? And so if that rule will follow, then that sequence is termed as arithmetic progression. Or in better way I will say, suppose when you are climbing a staircase, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, that way, no? So that means as you are crossing one by one step, you are approaching towards the next floor. So same is here. As we add 1 to 1, we'll proceed for the 2. If we add 1, 2, if we add 1, we'll proceed to 3. So that's what the reason it is an arithmetic progression. If anywhere you will find that it is not matching, that fixed term is not there, then it will not be in an arithmetic progression. See, as for example, if I take an example, see, suppose if I say that 5, then 9, then 12, then 17, then you see, here you see 4, here you see 3, here you see 5. So not a single one is matching. So this is not in AP. This is not in AP. Or this sequence is not in AP. But other all the three sequences are in AP. Clear? So please write down these three examples. And what is the arithmetic progression? Arithmetic progression. Now remember there are two more same way progression is there, and that is GP geometric progression, and there is HP harmonic progression. So there are another two. So these two is not there right at this moment, but that one is there. Okay, so related to progression there are three. One is arithmetic progression, geometric progression, and harmonic progression. Okay then. Then let's see. Now here, I'll just rub this part and see. I'll now explain you this one. See, when the year starts, suppose the year 2020, then January 1st, it was the first day. January 2 is the second day. January 3 is the third day. January 10 is the 10th day of the year. And similarly, if you approach 365 is the last day of the year. 365 is the last day of the year. So here also, you see, first, second, third, fourth, and go on. So first term, this is first term, this is first term, this is first term. So first term equal to A is divided by A. And you see here, 3, 3, 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 8, 8, 8. For this sequence, 8 is fixed. For this sequence, 3 is fixed. For this sequence, 1 is fixed. So that means what? In geometry, you got, if we take a common side, suppose this is, then this is another one, this one equal to this one equal to this, and if we write this one, then this one, what we are writing? Common side, that is both are common to the two triangles. So here also, as 8 is everywhere, the differences remain fixed, that is known as common difference, that is known as common difference. And common difference is divided by D. Common difference is divided by D. Clear? So first term you got, common difference you got. Now suppose, still now, if this is your, if this is the last term, here this is the last term, here this is the last term, after that no more term. After that no more term. And if this is the last term, this is, which is the term? First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Yes or not? So, that fifth term, second term, third term, these are denoted by AN. AN, suppose if I writing A5, that means fifth term. Clear? So this is, so if it is third term, A3, if it is fourth term, A4, if it is a 10th term, A10, like that. So N means what? What is, so A you got, common difference you got, what is A? A stands for number of terms. Number of terms. What is that? A stands for number of terms. Clear? So you got first term, you got common difference, you got nth term, then you got number of terms. So how many are known? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many are known? 1, 2, 3, 4. What is the first unknown? A. Second, D. Third, AN. Fourth, number of terms. Is it clear to you? I hope it is clear. Okay. So this is the example. So instead of A, multiple of 8, it may be multiple of 7, it may be multiple of 3, it may be multiple of 5, and many more. Okay. So still this one. Now, so progression you got. Now, before that, one more thing I want to clarify. That, just like length cannot be negative,
Is length can it be negative?
No, length cannot be negative. First thing.
Next, whether your age can be negative?
No.
Then, whether time can be negative?
No.
Okay. So as these things are not negative, number of terms also, that is, n also, n cannot be negative. First, this is the first.
Second, can I say that number of students present in the class 2.5? Number of people present in the meeting 100.5? Is it possible? Not possible. So n cannot be, fraction. Now next, when I say number of students present in the class is 0, means what? What do you presume? What do you understand? You will understand that school is closed. School is closed. Because if school is open, attendance cannot be 0. So n cannot be 0. If n equal to 0, then there is no sequence at all. Cannot be 0. So these are the three things you remember. N cannot be negative, n cannot be fraction, n cannot be 0. So these are the three things you have to remember for A. And for other, A, D, then another term, anything can be possible. It can be fraction, it can be negative, it can be 0 as well. No problem. Okay? So these are the things. Then, in exercise, then now we'll move to exercise 5.1. In 5.1, they are giving first one that takes if air after each kilometer, when fare is 15 for the first kilometer and 8 rupees for the additional kilometer, each additional kilometer. So suppose first 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer equal to how much? Rupees 15. If you go 2 kilometer, 2 kilometer equal to, you can write 1 kilometer plus 1 kilometer. Now, why I have written 1 kilometer? 1 kilometer is fixed 15 rupees. So, rupees 15. And after that, each kilometer is how much? Rupees 8. Rupees 8. Equal to how much? Rupees 23. Yes or not? Rupees 23. Okay?
Okay.
Then, next you see. Suppose 3 kilometer. 3 kilometer equal to 1 kilometer plus 2 kilometer. Why 1 kilometer and 2 kilometer? 1 kilometer is fixed. 15 rupees you have to give. Even though you travel only half kilometer. Then here rupees 15. And if after that if you travel 2 kilometer, 2 into rupees 8. 20 rupees 8 is 16 rupees 31. Clear? So then you see rupees 15, rupees 23, rupees 31. Then what? What is the difference? Rupees 8. What is the difference? Rupees 8. So according to our explanation, time whatever we got, what is that? It should be same. If after that 4 kilometer, then also it will remain same. So this is in happy. Therefore, it is in 1 Roman 1 in happy. It is in happy. Okay, but got it? Now, before that, so this is the first one, okay? First one. Then let's see next one. Roman 2.
Roman 2. Roman 2, you see, suppose you take 1 bill. This is a disabled. Now, if you give here, it is this much. Now, suppose you are taking out half of the year. Half you have taken out. Does it mean that it will not heat? It will not heat. You got in class 9 in chemistry chapter Avogadro's number. In Avogadro's number, it was given that 1 mole of anything equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. That is fixed. Yes or no? So here also 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. Here also 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. That means what? Even though you take out a yard, half of the yard from the balloon, that yard will push each and every corner of the wall of the balloon. That means it will not be in a P. Not in a P. Because you cannot count. You cannot count. Yes or no? Suppose 3 minus 2, it will reduce to 1. 1. But here, it is, remains the same. Each and every corner of the balloon is same because air pressure, you know air pressure. Okay. Now, next one is Roman 3. Roman 3 and 1 same. So, I will not explain. The next one you see, Roman 4. Roman 4 is a compound interest. Now, before compound interest, I will just explain what is simple interest and difference between simple interest and compound interest. You got in class 8. I think most of you remember the concept of simple interest and compound interest. Simple interest means interest only on principal. Only on principal. That means whatever amount you have invested. But CI means interest on interest. Interest on interest. So here, if first year is rupees 10, second year will be also rupees 10. But here, if first year is rupees 10, next year it will not be rupees 10. Because 10 was the interest, at the end of 1 year, if 100 rupees you have deposited and 10 is the rate of interest, 10 is the rate of interest, then at the end of first year it will be, at the end of first year it is rupees 10. At the end of second year, it is then also interest 10. But here, at the end of first year, it is remain same. But at the end of second year, it will be how much? Because it will be calculated here as well. So here as well means 10%. 10 into 10 divided by 100. So it will be rupees 11. So here you see difference is same. Here difference is not same. So that's why this is also not in FP. Not in AP. Okay, clear? Okay, then. This is the question number 1. Here 1, demand 4. Okay? Now, next is the Next is the that first four terms. So now write first four terms of AP. So 2 Roman 1. First equal to 10. Second 10 plus 10. 20. Third 20 plus 10. 13. Fourth 30 plus 10 equal to 40. Right? Now let's see 1 to 1, 5. 1 to 1, 5. First is what? Minus 1.25. Second, minus 1.25. Minus 0.25 equal to minus 1.50. Minus 1.50. Third equal to minus 1.50 minus 0.25 equal to minus 1.75. Minus 1.75. Okay, then let's see number 4. What is that? First is minus 1. So first minus 1. Second minus 1 plus half. So equal to half. Because if you take LCM, minus 1, plus 1, so minus half. Third, minus half, plus half, equal to 0. And so on, fourth also you can take out. And so on, fourth term as well. Okay? Now, let's see. Question number 3. So, did you copy? I hope you have copied. Okay. Then question number 3. So, for the following APs, write the first term and common difference. So, 3. Roman 1. A equal to 3. D equal to how much? 1 minus 3. Equal to minus 2. You can check next one also. This is D1. D2 you check. Minus 1. Minus 1. Minus 2. So common difference is minus 2. A equal to 3. Common difference minus 2. Suppose if I'll ask you Roman 3, then what will you do? A equal to 1 by 3, then D equal to 1 by 5 by 3 minus 1 by 3 equal to 4 by 3. Okay? 4 by 3 and so on. So common difference is 4 by 3. Common difference is 4 by 3. Okay? So, still that, this much will be homework, and also question number 4, Roman 6, I will give the homework. Okay, till then, bye bye, see you in the next.